Is it live?
Yes, it is.
Hi!
Wala pa. Ayun, bro. Ma'am. Ako itong muna nga yung kuputsero. Hello. Hi, Mon. You know Mon Kualupi?
Hello.
Hi.
Ikatapo.
Ikatapo.
Kuputsero ba niya? May kuputsero. Ang sabaw. Niya. Kutsara, put.
Dito na lang.
Ah, sige niya. Nawala nga kung ka ng gloves.
Na, Miss Larshan karon. Ania. Ania si, ano? Haji Balhaja.
Hello. Hi. Sa mga taga Davao diha nga matapa. Mga unta.
We are in Cebu, in the famous Larshan of Cebu. Kanang kani si Haji.
Unsa gani kani ano? Unsa gani kang basta teacher?
Teacher.
Spiritual advisor. Di ba guwapa ka yung spiritual advisor? Mo nang nainana sa basta.
That's a joke, basta.
Oh, mga unsa mo drink?
So we're here at Larshan. This is my favorite place for comfort food. Yeah, kadlawong dako. And I'm welcoming kani si Haji, who is here for a few days, for 2 or 3 days. He's from Davao, of course, supporter of the president, like most of us.
Most, John.
So. Dapat pala bali yung camera, dapat ako ganun. Yun, so nagkinamot mi diri ako, wala pa ako ang gloves.
Mga untan tanan.
So basa tag mga comments kadali. Hello. Ay, Lisa Label.
Onya, akong gloves na ma'am.
Pepsi is yours.
No.
It's okay, I can take this.
Sus. Sige lang. Pat Arial, hi. Cheryl Bahade Villamor, hello. Hi Ting, how are you? How are nothing, oh?
My friend, Tuting Dimitario, thank you. Hi. What's up, Manita? Daghan mo, Timmy.
Nakakadali siya. You want one more? My friend, Tuting Dimitario is, she was the one who sang with the president in
Where?
Hong Kong.
Ah, really?
Yung katong, ikaw yata yun eh. Ikaw ang bigay. Yun yata. Uh-huh. Tapos, one of the most talented people I know, ever. She can sing, she can dance, she can play the piano, she can draw, she's a champion dance porter.
Polyglot.
Grabe. Guapa pag yun.
Wow.
Kung siya yung babaeng version ko, o diba?
Oh my God.
Assuming. Anyway, Ting, oh, Larshan, we're gonna eat it for you and for everyone who has been here and who misses Cebu. Kel Garian Lomuntad, watching from Vegas. And Garshano Svensson. Ned Amping. Amping po diha. Dito Lesaka, hello. I miss Pochero from Cebu. Pochero, we will have it.
But si Haji has kaning
kinasun. Hambot nga nung ganahan siya kinasun. Reggie Chane Ko Galvez. Kailan daw interview ko ulit with President Arroyo. Wala na, yun na yun. Next namin kwentuhan ni Ma'am eh. Ano na, private na yun. Tapos, sino pa? Sarap talaga dito. La Arnie Frank Johnston, hello. Buti na lang nakita kita sa Senate hearing. Mabuti ba yun? But I was just telling
Haji,
the story behind the Senate hearing. Ulitin ko na lang, no? Kasalanan ko. Diba? Kinikwento ko kay Haji, kasalanan ko. Because, ikwento ko na lang, no? I set the interview between SAS and pasensya ha, may pimple. Nagbibinata. Or nagdadalaga. Whichever is applicable.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because we do not want to be confined, you know, by, you know, into labels and boxes.
Yeah.
So, ulitin ko, no? So, I set an interview with Senator Gordon. Senator Gordon and Sa, Senator Gordon and Thinking Pinoy. Like I did before with Governor Aimee Marcos. And yun naman kay Governor Aimee, kasali si Bruce, no? Iba-iba yon, iba-ibang schedule. Na actually, medyo sabay si Bruce at si Tita Aimee. Bruce at Tita Aimee at SAS. And then Thinking Pinoy was a different time. And then I had another one with Bruce and Status Hot. Nung bago lang, mga September na. So, parang ganun lang. Ang purpose po nun, gusto ko lang na eto mga our leaders, no? Our nations, our country's leaders are given the platform. Itong tatlo sila, or three or more, no? The same platform, the same opportunity to talk to you. Na hindi na lang puro kami. Hindi lang puro yung mga SOCMED, na DDS SOCMED. So that, kasi, kunyari, interviewin si Aimee sa TV, interviewin si Gordon sa TV, interviewin si Deputy Speaker Juan Garcia sa TV, mapapanood nyo. But iba yung experience ng ganito, di ba?
Social media.
It's more, it's real time, where you can comment real time and react, you know, with your likes and with your hearts, your angry faces, real time, no? And nababasa pa yung comments nyo. So that's what I want. I want more intelligent, credible talking heads, you know, na who are actual leaders, no? Decision makers in our country. And you can ask them the questions straight through SAS, RJ, as conduit. So yun ang I set it up and they at sa totoo lang po, I swear to God, you know, honest to God, and I'm a believer, so this counts.
Of course.
Walang bayad yun. Hindi, I cannot speak for their other activities and sa aking na alam, wala. But yung mga nasisineset up ko between them, even the side of Bruce, walang mga bayad yun. You know, nakakakain lang sila ng libre. Si Sas, walang pagkain kasi nasa The Hague. Or nung i-interview si Gordon, ano siya, nasa Paris. So, anyway, I set it up. Yun na yung akin. That's my purpose, no? Tapos, nag-decide ako magpunta ng Manila kasi mahirap naman kung utusan ko pa yung staff ni Senator Gordon na mag-set up ng FaceTime. Kasi may sistema na kami ni Sas. Mag-set up ng FaceTime para i-hook up kay Sas. And then si Sas, of course, i-hook up niya sa OBS niya to be broadcast live on Facebook. Ang hirap magbigay ng mga daming instructions. So, I decided to fly to Manila for that, no? Si TP, walang problema. Pwede ko namang arrange na kahit wala ako. Pwede naman, makita lang sila doon. And then I missed my flight. Kung nagpa-follow kayo sa akin even before the hearing, I missed my flight last Tuesday. That should have been a sign, no? Yeah. Na dapat hindi na ako tumuli siguro.
But what happened?
But I got a later flight. So, nung nandun na ako sa Manila, papunta na ng Senate, it was my decision basically whether yung interview with Senator Gordon either sa Senate office niya or sa Sofitel. Kasi sa Sofitel, wala sana ako sa hearing. At wala sana yung aming picture na nakaganon, no? Wala sana yon. But it was a decision. I just decided to have it at the Senate because, you know, the internet was fast enough. Nag-speed test naman kami. For convenience. For security. At kasi sa Sofitel, baka, you know, kumakain yung mga tao, maingay, may dadaanan. It might be distracting. So, after the interview, after SAS was RJ. Palabas na kami. Just to be clear, no, hindi yung binabastos ni RJ yung whatever was in his mouth. Kumuha siya ng a slice of pizza on our way out of Senator Gordon's office. At nagugutom ako. Sabi ko, ayoko na ng pizza kasi it's meaty. Gusto ko yung pizza na vegetarian. I like eat meat, no, but I have not all the time. So, not every kind of dish. So, sabi ko, gusto kumain sa ibang lugar. Tapos si RJ, in the mood mag-coke. Kaya mag-ingat siya, dalawang coke.
Oh my.
Oh, so, anyway, palabas kami, he grabbed a slice of pizza, tapos I think the next door, or two doors after, is on our way out, is Senator De Lima's office. Nandun yung number, hindi kami naglagay nun.
So who took the picture, Mike?
Yung isang volunteer ni Senator Gordon.
Aha.
Pero ako may idea, sabi ko, picture tayo. So, sorry ha, sorry to everyone. I'm not sorry. sorry, I'm not sorry, because the thing is, I will share to you that I was maybe in the next few days, some pictures of other people who've taken photos there before 222. Mm-hmm. So, ikaw, yun ang sinasabi ko, maglagay ka ng, tawag nito? Maglagay ka ng number na ganyan, keeping track of the number of days that he has been in detention. You don't expect people to take photos. And then you will control people if they will smile, laugh, or cry, or pout. Diba? Parang you will control that. Tangina, diba? I did not raise my middle finger. I did not raise my brow. I did not, hindi ako nagduling-duling-duling, hindi naman ako nanghiwi ba ng ganun. Diba? I just pointed at the door with the numbers that we didn't put and smiled. Hindi ko alam kasalanan pala mag-smile and offensive. Is my smile offensive? My God, I was in a Colgate commercial. Yeah, in 2010, 2011, oh, yeah. I was in a Colgate commercial, tapos offensive pala yung smile ko. Ngayon ko lang na-realize. So, yeah, sorry, medyo oily ang face kasi nandito kami sa Larshan. So, yun, no? And took a photo, I posted it. RJ took a photo with his phone, posted it through Thinking Pinoy, and I shared it. And yung aking status naman, yung aking naman caption to my photo, yung naka-ganun ako, ay naka-ganun lang. Sabi ko, 2 to 2 days in detention. That's matter of fact. That's not fake news. Diba? Tapos, matter of fact yun. Tapos meron lang emoji na nakatawa na lumuluha. O di at least lumuha. Ano bang gusto nyo? At least naiyak rin ako kahit pa paano. But if I put there that I was sad, that would have been fake news.
Wow!
Ayaw mo sa fake news. Ngayon nagpapakatotoo ako, galit kayo, di ba? So, anyway, yun ang nangyari. And we left. We had yan na yung aking sabaw. Salamat. And then we went to a place in Century City. Ay, hindi naman ganun kasarap. And then we adjourned at maybe 1 or 2 a.m. kasi si RJ was still testifying, no? So, pati masarap ng kain ni Haji. Kinamot yun. So, anyway. Yan na ba?
Ayan. Ito na ba lahat? Ito lang lahat.
Okay. So,
not sobrang dami na
niya. Anyhow, yun, no? I'll try to speed things up para... Kasi itong part na to, hindi mo na kwento, no? So, yun, and then, I was not going to go kasi hindi pa ako nakapagbanyo the following day hanggat na-mention si Nina Terol. At pagdating ko doon, nandito na ako sa likod, naka-huri, hindi handa. Si Franco, napaka-dress to kill. Diba? Naka-suit, naka-coat and tie, very sharply dressed, very dapper. Si RJ, naka-gusot mayaman na barong. Diba? Ako, naka-hoodie. Feeling Mark Zuckerberg lang. Diba? So, nandun ako sa likod, nakasandal ako sa pader. Unmindful of things, no? Tapos, katabi ko yung chief of political nakaibigan ko, ni Senator Gracie, Attorney Gary Jimenez. Alive ako, minention si Nina Terol. Yung expose, last expose ni TP. Na ako naman, I disagree with TP there. Kasi, pinsan ko siya. Tsaka parang, for me lang ha, 6 degrees of separation yon. Parang, si Nina Terol is a co-assistant editor of Cocoy Dayao in one of the websites, which was already there, if I'm not mistaken, even before Duterte became president. And I think even before Noynoy became president. So, hindi naman kasalanan maging associated kay Cocoy Dayao. She was staff also of Kiko and Bam. Naging staff naman siya ni Bam because she was the secretary general or secretary in the student council of Ateneo when Bam was president.
Okay.
Yun yung kanilang history. Pero mas mahaba naman history namin, pinsan ko siyang pinsang buo. So, but akin is, the logic for me there is, you don't need that. Because the fact of the matter is, Cocoy Dayao was the web security consultant of Noynoy. Noynoy is a liberal party. Bam and Kiko are liberal party. There you go. Okay. That is the connection. And I can make a million other connections I can make a million other connections between Cocoy Dayao and Kiko and Bam. And you want to make connections? Niña Terol, hindi lang siya masyadong proud. Pareho kami ng grandparents. So ang lola niya, Duterte. So kung gusto mo mag-engage in connections, isali mo rin yun. Niña's grandmother is a Duterte. Caridad Duterte. Ang grandfather niya, Captain Lopez, si Romualdez. So kamag-anak niya rin si Duterte at si Marcos. So, di ba, kung gusto mo i-connect si Niña, i-connect mo rin siya kay Duterte at Marcos, kadugo pa niya yun. So anyhow, yun, parang siguro nananahimik ako kasi ayoko namang matawag. Subuti naman, hindi ako minention ni TP at hindi rin ako minention ni Bam at ni Kiko. Alam ni Bam na kamag-anak ko. So, si Niña. Tapos, yung nasaan ang Pangulo naman, yung nasaan ang Pangulo na expose ni TP, minention rin ako doon sa article ni TP, sa first paragraph pa yata. Pero doon sa ano, hindi ko naman minention kung sino. Sinabi ko lang kay TP na, alam mo, meron akong kilalang publicist, sinabi niya na siya ang gumawa ng nasaan ang Pangulo. Ganito yan. Siya ang kinontract ng camp ni Marojas. Now, truth be told, possible naman na hindi talaga alam ni Mar. I'm saying this as one of the sources. Si TP na ang naghalungkat kung sino yung pangalan. Hindi ko sinabi yung pangalan. Sinabi ko lang may publicist na nag-contact sa akin asking for help at that time. So, to be fair naman, it's possible that Mar Rojas did not know. But this person should answer. If she's called to the Senate, she should answer why she was telling people, not just me, but other candidates, other campaign, you know, mga campaign officers of different parties. Bakit niya pinagkakalat na siya ang gumawa ng nasaan ang Pangulo dahil hinayang nga siya ni Mar. Ang alam ko ay ganito. Nung January 29, 2015, Thursday, see, I know my dates. That was the day na inuwi yung Sub 44 sa Villamor at wala si Noynoy. At he was at the Mitsubishi thing. So, hinahanap siya ng mga tao. So, mga alas tres, I was here at Chongwa Hospital, dyan sa taas, because my mom was in the ICU. She had a stroke early in the morning. And this publicist friend of mine called me to ask help for a list of hashtags. My friend Ryan V. Flores can even corroborate that, no, that date, kasi he gave me 10 of the 40 that I submitted.
Yeah.
The plan, sabi niya, is that Yusek Villarin of the office of Mar contracted her for Mar Rojas. Kaya hindi natin connect talaga kasi hindi naman talaga niya kamiting si Mar. But yung Yusek Villarin, DILG Undersecretary, Chief of Staff ni Mar, according to her, malay mo, nag-misrepresent itong correct si Iha. Hindi natin alam, baka hindi naman talaga kausap ni Yusek Villarin. Pero klaruhin na yan, bakit niya pinagsasabi sa napakaraming tao na si Yusek Villarin, na Chief of Staff ni Mar Rojas, ang kumontak sa kanya na gumawa ng ganitong ng hashtag. Yun na nga yun. Yung appealing hashtag is nasaan ang Pangulo to be rolled out by 6 p.m. in Twitter. And you know what? In an hour, it was trending Philippine-wide and worldwide. And then it topped the worldwide trends.
Uh-huh.
And then by 12 midnight, 6 hours after, it had already garnered 500,000 impressions. And of course, naturally, it spilled over to mainstream media. So anyway, yun na naman. Parang, oh my God, ako may alam na naman ako dito. Ako na naman. From Niña Terol to nasaan ang Pangulo, sana hindi ako matawag. Tapos, I survived that. Eh, biglang tinawag ako ni Kiko Pangilinan. Dahil dun sa picture nga na yun, accidental, but it was just a spur of the moment thing. Tinuro namin yung pintuan na nga, like I said, hindi naman kami naglagay ng number, at ibang tao naman sa internet nagpa-picture rin dun, but hindi sila pinupuntirya.
Uh-huh.
Tapos bilang, where is Mike Acevedo Lopez? So from the back of the set of that hall, nagsandig sa pader, tawag nito, forget na may Tagalog. Ano, tinawag ako. Sandal sa pader. So, you know, the senator's here and ano, I wave, so I'm here. Kasi naman, when they call your name, you come forward, no? Wala naman akong kinakatakot. And then I swore, I took my oath by myself.
And you sat beside RJ.
Yes, that's why. Sabi ba kong ka-friend sa Senate, that was the most, the grandest entrance of any Senate, parang resource person in a Senate hearing that they know of. Sabi ko, well, what am I going to do? But yun na yun. That was the story behind that. And, well, I hope you picked up also na yung mga sineset up kong mga interviews with these two, if it's right to call them factions now, SAS TP etong side nila Bruce, hindi sila binabayaran, that much I can say. I do it with them, I collaborate with them. I think it's more than anything it's called collaboration, because I want, in my opinion, I want more talking heads nga. Who defend the president and who are able to explain very well what's happening to our country from wherever they are, no? I mean, Marcos is local government, Dick Gordon is in the legislature, yun lang yun. So, at nagugutom na ako. Kaya hindi pa ako kumakain since afternoon. So, in honor of my friends, no? Ay, eto yung Dicer.
Yeah. Super sarap. You should visit Cebu.
Dicer is like the barbecue sauce that you normally... Wala. Yung sing-sing ko na stuck. Dicer is the barbecue sauce you normally have. Yung inaano sa barbecue, yung pinapahid. Here, you can ask for it in Larshan. And then, imimix mo siya with your toyo, kalamansi, suka, at sili. Kung gusto mo na manghang. So, that's what makes it special. And, huling pa ako. So, in honor of my friends, RJ, Sas, and Bruce, and his friends in Status Hot, sila Rocky, sila Andrew, at some point, I'm sure we'll all be friends again, maybe not like before. Yeah. This is for you. Bantay daw sa bill, hindi. Okay na dito kasi I'm a suki here.
Bantay siya?
Sa bill, kasi minsan daw hindi na kukompute ng maayos. Lukit man ko nito. Anyway, I'm gonna eat first. It's not nice to be... daming comments. Sorry, hindi ko na mabasa. Miss you, Ting. Iron Raquel. Hi. Of Governor Amy Marcos. Hi, Kat. Kat Domingo. Kathleen. Basta. Basta, ang akin lang ay...
Ang daming love.
I wish DDS... Ang hiling ko lang dun sa lahat, no? Wag na natin palakihin. Let's not take sides. Let's just give people some space, some time to lick their wounds, to reflect, and because time heals all wounds. No? Wag natin palakihin. Alam mo ang nananalo pag ganyan, it's the yellows. Wag tayong pumayag na pinagpipiestahan. Tama si Bruce, wag tayong OA mag-react. Nagkagalit sila, ganun na yun. Yeah, they made it public, so we can't do anything. And everybody feels that they have a say because it was made public. But, you know, you're free to react however way you want to react. If you're pissed, if you're happy, if you're sad, if you're disgusted, that's on you, no? I will not stop you from reacting the way you want to react, the way you feel like reacting, because ayoko na pinapakilaman ang aking reactions. Mm-hmm. Diba? Ang aking freedom, it's my freedom of self-expression. Kagaya ng picture, hindi pa rin pakilaman. Diba? Pero... meron lang akong hiling na dalangin, hope, no, na we can move past this, we can be above things, and let's just focus on what's more important for our country, and that's supporting the president, because this is not a good time, no? In fact, this is the worst time for him in terms of the ratings and the black propaganda that's still pervasive everywhere, here and abroad, and it does not help that the people who help curb the black propaganda, who help who speak up for the truth and who disabuse people of their mistaken notions are fighting and are tapos na intriga pa, diba? So yun lang, let's just focus on what's most important. All right, can't read all the comments anymore, I'm so hungry. Thank you for watching us. This is Mike signing off. Haji Balahaja.
Good night,
fresh
everyone.
fresh from Davao, we're here at Larsen Cebu. Bye. Di ko ma-press.